Hey everybody, so I'm back to film a really quick video again before school, so if I talk fast, you guys know why. So lately I've been addicted to contouring my cheeks. I always go on and off through this addicted contouring phase. I don't always contour my cheeks, but sometimes I just can't help it. And for those who don't know what contouring is basically the use of shading to slenderize certain features or make certain areas seem a little bit more darker, which gives a shadowing effect, which makes everything else look a little bit slimmer. And there's a million how-to contour videos all over YouTube. I'm only gonna focus on contouring the cheeks in this video because I don't really contour my nose much. Actually, I never really contour my nose. But if you guys are trying to figure out how to contour your nose, and I'm pretty sure if you search it, there'll be a million videos popping up. And this tutorial is gonna be super quick. I haven't contoured yet, so I'm gonna show you guys how to do this, and then I'm gonna be off to school. So to start off, I'm going to show you guys what brushes I prefer to use when I contour. The first one is by Crown Brush. It's their BK31 flat top brush, and it's just a nice fluffy flat top brush that fits really well in the hollows of your cheeks. The other brush is by Sigma, and it's a dome shape round contour brush. It has a lot of precision, so it makes it easy to get the product where you want it to be. When it comes to what products you can use, there's so many options. You can use a darker foundation, cream blush, darker face powder. There are so many options. You can use anything you have. I personally find bronzer is the easiest to use. I'm showing you guys two of my favorites. One's limited edition, but if you can still get your hands on it, I would recommend it. The other one isn't. The first one has slight shimmers in it, but luckily the shimmers don't really show. I would definitely recommend aiming for a matte bronzer because they just are a little bit more flattering, and just aim for something that's about 2 to 3 shades darker than your skin tone. So what I like to do is just load up one side of my brush with just sweeping it into the bronzer. And then I like to follow the guideline between the top of my ear to the corner of my mouth, which is where you want to aim your bronzer, and just start working it in as like a sharp angle into the hollows of your cheeks and start doing little circular motions to blend everything out. I did it a little bit heavier today just so the camera could pick it up really well so you guys could see where I'm placing it. But just work on blending it out and blending it back into the hairline. I don't bring the powder all the way towards my mouth. I bring it about halfway, and you can really feel it sinking into the hollows of your cheeks. If you make a fishy face, you can see where your cheekbones are, and it goes right underneath it. And then I use whatever's left on the brush to contour my forehead just a little bit. I don't have that big of a forehead, so I don't really go to the extreme with this contouring. I just use whatever left and apply on the sides and the very top of my hairline. So if you apply too much or you have any harsh lines, you can always go over it with your face powder brush. Even if it has a little bit left over face powder on it, it will help blend out all the edges and soften everything up to make it look more natural. So then if you want to, you can grab whatever blush you're using that day and just apply it onto the height of your cheekbones, starting at the apples and just blending it back into the hairline. And all you have to do is place your blush right above the hollows of your cheeks, above the contour.
Then you're basically done. Now you have a nice slenderized effect on your face. It makes it look just a little bit healthier. This really comes in handy for those who feel like they have like chubbier cheeks or a fatter face and they prefer. And there's nothing wrong with it. It's not like it's surgery or anything. It's just like a temporary little shading. It gives just a nice effect, especially when you smile. It just makes your cheekbones look a little bit more defined. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in a later video.